say that when I came to the loft, and I already, me and George already going to the garage, we thought we were dancers, you know? I went to the loft, and I was actually intimidated because the guys were doing, like, things that we never ever saw. And they were so different in their own way that you gave them as much respect that we couldn't even get on the floor, George and I. We wouldn't dare make a move because we were like, this is the real deal. We're like
big time.
We're in neck high in dancers, and I'm not gonna put myself out there. And it was still a competition thing with me, because when I used to go to the garage, I thought I was getting my groove on. But when I went to the loft, everybody was cool, but I was still on this. I'm gonna show somebody what I can do.
We do have to mention,
when I went there, it was totally different. Everybody was like, it wasn't about what you can do. It's about you brought your own and you danced on your own. People like Willie, like Nervous Mike.
Yes,
I look at these guys, Archie, and I was look at these guys, and I would say, you know what? I got to go back home. I got to go take my notes. I got to come back, and I got to come correct. Because where I was coming from, my style wasn't kicking. Eventually, I got enough confidence to bring my own style to the floor.
But you know what? It was clickish, but at the same time, it changed because we realized that whenever we were out, we were in there, we go and bonded with each other because we knew, even from different cliques, we bonded with each other.
the circle has to do with a camaraderie. It's a camaraderie thing that you go in there, you're like, you're giving it all, and it doesn't matter if your move isn't as nice as the other kid. Yeah, everybody's doing their own thing.
Like the
and then when you're done with that move, it doesn't matter who's better.
Love,
you share that love, and you tell them, you know what, you're in there, you gave your best.
We're talking about circles. It wasn't just circles. It was circles, and it was everybody around
that's
them
the difference.
Dancing among the circle.
But that's the difference.
All right?
That's
because
the difference of it all.
The dancers are dancers, but don't forget the people that don't know how to dance as good as the dancers. All
listen,
right? Because they're the ones that made the club also. Because
exactly.
If they wasn't in the club, there wouldn't be no money generated, right. And there would be no dancers.
But the dancers
right?
Are getting in.
So the dancers.
For free.
Were,
yeah.
Listen, one thing about it too.
Also, there was a ritual in the paradise. I'm talking about every single person in this club will sit down in the circle one by one. Everybody did their thing, if
yep.
They knew how to dance or not. And then we all stood there.
It was beautiful.
And it was just one big happy family.
Wait.
And afterwards, then we all integrated together in this one powwow in the circle. And it
yep.
Was all the time ritual form.
But
we look forward to that.
I have to say one thing. When you say about the circle did not come until the last 10 years.
Yeah.
We
right.
Never did circles because
we
had no circles. No circles. Circles are the last thing in the world.
Circles
you
was
have.
A garage thing.
You start
the
having
circles.
Circles
was a garage thing.
When you start
talking
about, we will warm up. We will warm up in the crystal room.
Let me explain to you.
We will warm up in the crystal room
circle.
And then go off to the side room and tear it up. And then on the dance floor, there was that springboard in the middle of the dance floor that all dancers knew about.
But wait a minute. Let me explain something. Wait.
Okay.
When you talk about that damn circle, all right? The circle can be discriminative to a lot of people, and especially when it comes down to people who want to learn how to party. Where we came from, we didn't have a circle, so no one felt intimidated.
Right.
When you
yeah.
Have a circle, you now ostracize everybody else behind
yeah.
You. No women get into circles when they do, and if they do, they got to be extremely good dancers. But the problem was, where we came from, there was no such thing as a circle. There was a 5-ring circle. There was a 6-ring. There was
yeah.
17 rings.
Yeah.
Every little corner that you went to had different people
every
who could dance.
Room.
And it wasn't about that. I'm being cool because I'm in a circle. I banned the circle. The only reason why I danced a few minutes in there was because I realized I was around family, around friends, and I could do that. But when it comes down to being in a circle, then you're discriminating. And it's all right to show your best moves. It's all right to be as nasty as possible. But when you start letting other people who don't feel that they can go and hang out with you feel intimidated, they don't want to dance.
Right.
Okay, now, no, that's not right. Wait a minute.
True,
from now,
true.
Dancer to dancer. It's just like disc jockey to disc jockey. For me. Out of all the years, I just hit 34 years old.
Wow.
Ever since I could understand what dancing was in Paradise Garage, to me, we was telling a story.
Which was like, you true.
And I'm saying, I would go out there, put my little minute in, step out. The next brother or sister will go out.
Yeah.
And I'm saying, but some people took it in offense.
Yeah.
Maybe,
exactly
right, the outsiders, but
exactly
us of being inside, giving this off, we knew we was telling a story. We're talking to one another.
But that's where we have to explain that to everybody else because
we're
they don't understand that.
We're doing
yes.
It now.
Well, you see, it's the out when the outsider is looking in,
the
outsider has a concept
right.
Of it being competitive because, first of all, they're in awe of what they see. Now, the only way you can encourage someone is you cheer them on.
Right.
Even if they fuck up, even if they don't even want to get into
that's
the circle.
What we were saying
you
earlier.
Can be busting your step and you see a brother back there just looking,
we said
you
that
invite
earlier.
Him
into
in.
The circle.
That's right.
You invite him in.
You chant him on.
You let him know
different.
That it's okay.
That's why the law
you know?
Is important because the law, we clap after we heard a song. They don't clap after they hear a song
that's
in
right.
There unless it's the last song. And what happens is that when you're in there and you're enjoying yourself and you go ahead and getting your groove off and everything else and you hear a fantastic record and the record ends, you hear an applause, you realize the DJ did his magic. He did
that's
his
right.
Job. He made you feel happy, and everybody else knew it.
A wonderful music
but
appreciation.
That's 2 minutes.
Okay.
Right.
There
but
you
sometimes
go.
With the circles, there's only a certain amount of room, and you got to share the room with everybody. And some people just want to do their little two-step, and they need that room. And sometimes the circles take up a whole lot of room,
yeah.
And people can't
people
dance.
Get offended.
Got
to
share the floor with
that's
everybody.
Right.
You want to show off? Cool, but. You gotta share the floor with those kids.
A real dancer shows self-control.
Yes.
He knows he could jump in and do a handstand, a curl, or sweep, whatever, and he won't do it. Why? Because he's enjoying to see the other people that are learning to dance and enjoying themselves.
Nah, Ozzy's better.
Why is it better?
Why? It's a free, you know. Not everyone has an original, you know.
He means original style. Yeah.
What I'm gonna do sometimes in the dance floors, I never know. I just go with it, you know? Just go with the music. But it's not about, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8, 5, 6, 7, 8, knowing the moves, knowing the counts. It's just about knowing that beat and what to hit it and feel it, you know? It's about dancing and being free. Every track after track, I was just like, oh my God, this is me. I just want to go for it, you know? Woo!
It's a small room, like 12 feet.